What's going on, guys? This is Bryce from Comical Penguin, and we're here with a new weekend series game, What Remains of Edith Finch. It's supposed to be a shorter game. Got some adventure exploration elements to it, so kind of looking forward to this. Okay. Well, I guess I'm just looking around. I'll be honest, I don't know a whole lot about this game. Oh. Okay.
A lot of this isn't going to make sense to you. I'm sorry about that. I'm just going to start at the beginning with the house. I lived here until I was 11, but I wasn't allowed inside half the rooms.
I'm gonna be honest, this drew my attention, but I don't know if it was supposed to... Nope. Okay.
Inside the mailbox were bills from 7 years ago, marked urgent, open immediately.
Oh. Okay.
I hadn't been back since my brother Lewis's funeral. In her will, my mother left me a key, but didn't tell me what it unlocked. Maybe she thought I'd know. Or she thought that the mystery would be enough to bring me back.
I'm honestly confused.
No one had driven this way in a long time, but I saw his footprints.
Oh, it's just a deer. Can I follow it? No. Nope.
The truth is, even after I inherited the house, I never thought I'd come back to it. But now I had questions about my family that only the house knew the answers to. The house was exactly like I remembered it, the way I'd been dreaming about it. As a child, the house made me uncomfortable in a way I couldn't put into words.
Oh.
Now, as a 17-year-old, I knew exactly what those words were. I was afraid of the house. I hoped the key might unlock the front door. It didn't. Looking in, I felt like the house itself had been waiting for me.
Hmm. That's just a leaf. Gotta be something back here, I guess. No way. We're not going in through that, are we?
Crawling through the doggy door used to be a lot easier when I was 11.
I mean, there's a... The door is literally ajar.
First time in years, I felt like I was home. But instead of a family, there were just memories of one. Like how after Lewis started working at the cannery, we all got sick of eating salmon. Except our cat, Molly. Nothing in the house looked abnormal. There was just too much of it. Like a smile with too many teeth. Great-grandpa Sven built a music box for Barbara, along with the rest of the house. Mom always told me to stay out of the basement, so I wasn't really surprised when the key didn't fit. Even the fireplace had a story. Edie told me the bricks came from the original house, after it sank. The table was still a wreck from the night we left. My mom was the only one of us who could imagine. It was like a bomb had gone off, killing everyone but sparing the furniture.
Okay, well, that's... Dang it, I missed that. Oh my goodness, that bicycle wheel scared. Gave me a little bit of the heebie-jeebies.
My mom wasn't much of an optimist, but she never stopped believing that my brother Milton was alive.
What a weird looking door.
After Milton disappeared, Mom sealed up all the bedrooms. Then Edie retaliated and drilled peepholes. Molly always seemed like a girl I could imagine being friends with, if she hadn't died in 1947.
So there's a... So that's what this was. It was a...
Edie told me once that every Finch who ever lived is buried somewhere in the library.
What? That's gotta be fake, right? That can't be real.
I spent a lot of time playing in Great Uncle Walter's room. I think my mom sometimes regretted not sealing it up. Lewis told me there were secret passages, but I never believed him.
Ooh.
Turns out, my mom was really good at keeping secrets. Now it was time to find out what my mom had been afraid of.
I don't know if I want to come in here yet. Oh.
From the paintings on the wall, it was clear my brother Milton had been here before me. Reading this, maybe it sounds like I had a plan. But I had no idea what was behind that door. Just like I had no idea where all this was gonna lead.
This is Molly's room.
December 13th, 1947. Dear Diary, I'll be gone soon, but I wanted to tell somebody about what's gonna happen. It started when Mom sent me to bed without dinner. I woke up and I was starving, so I looked around for something to eat. The gerbil food was dry, but I didn't mind.
What?
My Halloween candy was all gone.
She ate her toothpaste.
I ate a lot of things that night. Then I heard chirping outside my window. It was a barn swallow going back to her nest. I reached out for her. And suddenly, I was a cat.
What?
Mom and Dad didn't even look at me.
What a...
I jumped and I almost got... I could tell she was getting really tired. Now I was up in the big tree. I promised Dad I wouldn't climb it. All I cared about was eating that gummy bear. I gobbled her up. And suddenly, I was an owl. First, all I heard was the wind. Then I heard little teeth nibbling in the grass.
What?
Too big to care. I started choking, but I couldn't stop eating. And suddenly, I was a shark.
Oh my. Oh no.
Into the ocean. But now, I was hungrier than ever. I wanted fat, juicy seeds. I tore off her flipper, and it tasted really good.
Where's the rest of her at? Oh, there she is.
Grabbed that tight. But I was so hungry, I jumped out of the water. When I opened my eyes, everything changed. And I smell people up.
What in the world is going on?
I was big.
This story's gotten really weird.
What? I slithered onto the sand, and the good smell went into an old pipe.
At the end of this, are we going to say that Molly is still the cat? This is her bedroom.
I got closer and closer.
No. I'm not sure anymore.
All my stomach started growling. And suddenly, I was me again. I held my breath for a long time, but I couldn't hear anything. I think it's waiting for me to fall asleep. But it's not going to wait much longer. It needs to be, and we both know I will be delicious.
What?
I'm not sure if I believed all of that, but I'm sure he would have. This will be obvious later, but my mom never told me any of the stories. He would have that mom didn't like bringing up the past. So, when we adopted a stray kitten, she was the one who named it Molly. I spent a lot of time in Great-Grandma Edie's room. The room was like a museum. For 500 years, the Finches have been famous throughout Norway for their fortune and misfortune. Odin Finch buries the latest victims of the family curse, his wife Ingeborg and their newborn son, Johan. On January 7th, 1937, he set sail with his family and his house. But 40-foot waves off the coast of Washington send the house and Odin to the bottom of the sea. Odin's daughter Edie, with husband Sven and baby Molly, step ashore in their new home, Orcas Island. Odin Finch is the first to be buried in the new family cemetery. His daughter Edie is already dreaming of a new Finch house.
Okay.
Whatever's wrong with this family, it goes back a long ways.
So, I mean, I'm Edith in this story, right? Right? Oh. Okay.
When Edie told people Sven was killed by a dragon, she could also have said he was building a dragon-shaped slide that collapsed. She could have, but she didn't.
What a...
One summer, they evacuated the island, but Edie refused to go. For a few weeks, she was a celebrity. I hadn't thought of myself as Edith Jr. for a long, long time. Edie gave a big interview about a mole man living under the Finch house. My mom was furious. Even in her 90s, sometimes Edie seemed a lot younger than my mother.
Oh my.
The only trace Grandpa Sam's first wife Kay left on the house was the pink bathroom.
What in the world?
It was a pretty big trace.
Oh, that's... You think? No way, this is... They're all the same lock.
There's a secret in this bathroom. It's in the last place you would look. It isn't in the cupboard. It's hidden in this book.
That's interesting. What in the world?
Sven gave Sam an old camera he'd refurbished. He never put it down.
That is funny.
I knew Grandpa Sam had a twin. And that he never talked about it. I guess my grandpa didn't like history any more than my mom did. How I Want to Remember My Brother by Sam Finch. The thing I remember is that when he made up his mind, that was it. My brother said he'd die before he even heard about me. And he did. At Barbara's funeral, he swore he'd never be afraid again. And he wasn't. I think Calvin always wanted to fly. But that day, he finally made up his mind to do it.
No way.
I told him going around was impossible. Maybe if I hadn't said that.
Calvin, I'm not gonna tell you again.
Maybe if the wind hadn't picked up. Then maybe he'd still be here. But I doubt. I think he'd already made up his mind. That's what I want to remember about my brother. The day he made up his mind to fly. And he did.
Oh.
After the funeral, Edie rubbed off Calvin's hat in the room.
I mean, just
Mom said Grandpa Sam enlisted at 18. Never set foot in the room again.
Yeah.
Passages were a pretty tight fit. They'd obviously been built for smaller hands and bellies. Barbara was a child star for 2 years. Until America grew out of it.
Interesting.
Whenever people ask me about my family, the first thing they always want to know about is Barbara. The last time I was in Edith Senior's room, I was 10 and she was painting my portrait. As a kid, I just assumed every house had peepholes and sealed rooms you weren't allowed inside of. My Grandpa Sam spent 7 years sharing a room with his dead brother, Calvin.
I kind of do want to, like...
Edie's father, Odin, built the original house. Mom must have locked the third floor stairs when the night he left.
Makes sense.
Growing up, I always thought of Barbara as a child star.
Oh, I didn't want to get back in here. I guess we can't look back out through the peephole. Makes kind of sense, I guess.
I never thought about how hard it must have been for her afterwards. Of all the stories people wrote about Barbara's death, I'm surprised Edie saved this one.
Oh, Jack, Ina, with another ghastly tale inspired by America's most unimaginative act. I'm calling it The Surprise End of Barbara Finch. Barbara was famous for her scream. Now at 16, she was all washed up, a has-been. But in a lucky break, she'd been asked to perform her signature scream at a local convention for monster movie girls. It was just a boost for me. Unfortunately, the scream hadn't aged well.
Getting better? I think you just need the right motivation.
The biggest fan had come to boil. Rick was about to demonstrate when...
grade 3.
It was Barbara's father, Sam. He'd slipped into a table saw and had to be rushed to the emergency room. So Barbara got stuck babysitting her youngest brother, Walter. An adventure was canceled.
Okay, I'm hearing frustration, but I'm not hearing terror. What if I tried...
A gang of hoodlums and Halloween masks have been terrorizing Orca's Island tonight. Police are urging residents to...
That came from the basement.
You're right. Also, I loved your delivery plans. Why is your basement door locked?
Because my dad likes making puzzles and secret puzzles. There's a key hidden in the music box. The secret is to keep winding and winding until finally the key pops out.
Thanks, man. I'll be back in a sec.
20 minutes later, Rick hadn't returned. So Barbara went to look for him. Right on cue. She reached for the music box. And when she found the key, she listened for Rick. But the house... She found Rick's crutch and imagined the worst.
I mean, it's got to be through here, right?
The gang's leader is the infamous Hookman killer, Dr. Carl Hamill, who impaled and then ate his family 10 years ago tonight.
Which one's Walter's room? Oh, I guess it doesn't matter. I've been set this way. Oh, this is Walter's room. Oh, that's right, we know this way right here. He's gone, isn't he? Yep, he's gone. Okay, well, this game is much different than I imagined it would be.
Edie told me all Barbara wanted was to be remembered, as absurd as that comment was. Maybe what Edie saw was a happy ending.
I mean, I guess the idea here is that I go back through here to... I mean, that does tell...
I guess now I know why Mom didn't like me playing with the music box.
Yeah, that makes sense. It got dark, too.
A lot of things got left behind when we went out last night.
There it goes. I actually I thought it's gonna be the end of our episode today. We've learned about a few of the family members here. Strangely enough, like, you look at all these guys and every one of them, like, died, like, really early in life. I mean, Odin was was what? 57 when he passed away. Edie actually had a long life there. Oh, 93. Wow. Walter, another one who made it fairly. And the little Leaf is who they married. That's. Oh, I didn't realize that. Lebranchas are, it's a little difficult to understand. I'm guessing her mother's name was Dawn and married Sanji. Okay. I see, I think. But yeah, I mean, as you look at it, I mean, like, Walter lived, I mean, what, 50, 53? Still, I mean, we know Sven, I mean, Ingeborg and Sven had, Ingeborg died of a disease, Sven died because a dragonfly crushed him. I mean, Sam here was 33, we don't know his or Walter's death yet. Calvin was 11, Barbara 16, Molly 10, I mean, yeah, Gregory here was a year old, Gus is another one who was, 13, I mean, even Dawn here was... ...48 when she passed. Milton was 11. Lewis was at 22. Yeah. Okay, well, I mean, honestly, interesting story so far, guys. I'm confused by the game, to be completely honest. I understand we're coming back to her old house, learning about the things that happened, but, like, honestly, what happened? I'm guessing it's, like, 2016, 2017 then, because she's inherited this house. So, I am interested to see, like, what happens as we continue to go. Hey guys, we'll see you next time. See you guys. Bye.